guys, welcome back to another episode of Creator Bros. In today's video, we're looking at how you can create a vintage logo design in Adobe Illustrator. In the previous part of this video, we have created out this amazing vector logo design. First one was helmet with a nice retro look. Then this one with a nice workshop logo, which is quite unique. Then we have created this anchor ship logo with a classic look to it. Now in this tutorial, we're using those vectors and create out a vintage logo with a nice background color to the vector object. We have created that using the image. And lastly, we have created this design. So let's begin with the designing process. Let's move on to the second last design. So for the second last design, we have given some different style to this. As you can see, we have added some yellow background in the shape, and if you check it out over here, we don't have any background in the background, so we need to get that. So to get that background, what you need to do is we'll bring in our original image. So just go back to your file, and here is our original all image. So just drag and drop it to Illustrator and just click on 16 color image trace, and this will trace out the image. And after that, expand it, then ungroup it and delete the border and delete all the unnecessary shapes that you don't need, like this one, delete it out, this white, delete it out, this one, delete it out. So just keep only the necessary shapes, and now we'll select all and then go to Pathfinder and unite them, and then double click inside, select everything, deselect our main shape and delete it out. So we are left with the shape. Yep, and let's scale down the size. So let's scale it down and place it somewhere around here. And for this, I'm gonna choose this color. So let's choose this color, orange, yellow color. So this is the color code, E8AB5F. This is the color code. Click OK. And now let's adjust the size accordingly. So I'm gonna use the ruler, Command Control R, and bring out the ruler. And place one on top of the head and the other on the bottom of the leg, something here. Okay, now we'll place it somewhere around here and we'll adjust the top strip. So with the shift press, just scale it down until it matches with the ruler, something like that. Okay, and for the bottom as well, like now if I place it, slide it on the left with the shift press and place it under it like this and arrange it back and just bring it on. Yep, you can see the border on the back. So you can just move around just to like, you can just move it a little bit up, something like that, and from the top. Yep, so once you have placed your background shape like that, I'll just remove these rulers and I'll select them and group them up. Control G. So our owl is also ready to be designed. So place this owl over here, and now let's draw this text. So what we did over here is we need our ellipse tool, and with the alt press, click and drag and create an ellipse, something like this. And with the space bar, you can move around, and let's place it somewhere around here. Okay, and a little narrower, as you can see in our design, it's narrow, and it finishes somewhere around here. Let's keep some space as well, something like that. Okay, and I'll leave it. Now to this, I'm gonna apply some stroke color just to see it. And now let's apply this text. So what I'll do is I'll just go in there, copy them, Command O, Command C, and select this ellipse. Select a text tool, type on path tool, click on it, and Command V. And the font we have used is STIX General Bold. And let's do the placement. So here it is, you can do the placement. One around this much and the other end around this much. Okay, let's scale down the overall size, something around like that. Okay, and this one, go to character and let's increase the font size. 15 is good enough. And let's do the adjustments. So one around here and that's around here. So that's how you do the adjustment of the text. And if you go into the character, you can see this is text is 15 pixel, and I have given some spacing just to make sure that they are covering the whole circle, semicircles like that. And I just reduce a little bit. And now let's add these strokes. So we'll use the line segment tool, and from here, click and drag and create outer line. Apply color, brown color maybe. Yep, 1 pixel. Just make a little bit bigger. And this one, let's extend, put it up a little bit up. And this one around this much. And I'll just reduce the spacing of the text. Like that. And this line will place it somewhere around here. And I'll create one more duplicate of it and place it somewhere around here. Like that. And let's cut this division. So I'm going to use the scissor tool and give one cut, other cut around here. Do the same for this. Okay, first of all, select that. And use the scissor tool and give one cut around here and the other around here. And selection tool, delete, selection tool, delete. And here it is. And now let's put the sticks. So I'm going to use the sticks as well. Place it around here and just scale on the size a little bit, and yep, like that. And this one, these two, let's move it up a little bit. And I'm going to copy this. This is STX general font, and this one, super Clarendon regular font. So I'll just place this around here. Okay, this one will extend it using the selection tool. Do the same for the other as well. I'll use the rulers just to make sure they are properly aligned, like that, and like from this side as well. Okay, so using this transform tool, just make sure they are properly aligned to align them. Okay, so this is how we have created this design. I'll just remove the ruler now, and next we'll create out this logo. So to create out this vintage logo, let's create out this ellipse first. So I'll just scale down the size a little bit and place it around here. Now let's draw the ellipse. Use the ellipse tool and click and drag and draw the ellipse like this. So with your press, just make oval and place it somewhere around here and scale it up a little bit, something like that. Yeah, I'll just make it stroke, and let's give it thickness around 0.8 pixel, something like that. Now I'll go to object path, offset path, and give some inner strokes as well. So this one I'll increase it to around, let's say, yep, 5. Click OK, and let's give it a stroke thickness around, let's say, 3, and we'll keep it inside, or maybe center is fine as well. So once we have added these two borders, let's type out this text. So I'll create one more object path, offset path. And this one, I'll go inner with a little bit of gap, something like that. And to this, we're going to add a text. So we just go in there and copy this. Command Alt C and select this, and text tool, type on path, click on it, Command V, and here it is. Let's scale down the size around this much. Let's move it around. So selection tool, and let's move it around this one. Move this top surface around this much. So let's make it a little bigger. So I'm going to go to character and increase the size a little bit, this much. Yep. And let's play around with this size. So let's make it a little bit narrow on this side. This looks great. Let's make it a little bit long. Something like that. So this is how you can add these texts in a circular way. And now let's duplicate this and place it somewhere around here. Okay, this is Palatino linotype, and I'll just copy a star and place it somewhere around here. And for this ribbon effect, what we'll do is we'll choose something this, just drag and drop it over here. And to make that curve effect, we'll go to object, amulet restore, make with wrap, and let's increase the wrapping value, something like this. And I'll just place this around here, and let's scale this up, something like that. Okay, so once you have placed that, we are leaving some space for text as well. Let's increase the size a little bit and place it somewhere around here, giving a space for text. This one, we can increase the size a little bit. Yeah, and let's copy this text. This is the same font. I'll place it around here and scale the size a little bit up. And this text century, to create that, we'll be using typing out the text the same way. So text S-A-N-T-U-A-R-Y century. The font I'm using is Leg Gothic for regular. So copy it like that and select this and paste it over here. Command B, enter. And this is the font. And we'll go to character and reduce the spacing to 0. Let's scale up the size, and here it is. You can see, set the spacing a little bit. So let's keep it around 20. Yep, and place it on somewhere around here. And let's reduce the height a little bit and increase the size a little bit, something like that. And now to get that little curvish effect, we'll go to object, amblip distort, make it web, and give it a little slight curve. Something like that, and place it somewhere around here. You can reduce the size a little bit, and here we go. We have added that text. And to add this circular curve, we use the pen tool. So I'll just reduce the size a little bit more, and let's use the pen tool. So pen tool, click, click, and draw the curve, and apply a stroke, and choose black color or any color you like. Apply stroke, like select the stroke and go to stroke and choose this pointed, both side pointed shape, and give it a stroke thickness. So let's give it around 0.5 and create one more duplicate of it. Place it down, scale down the size, and done. So this way we have added that text. Now let's change the color. So first thing, select this and let's choose a color. So for this one, double click on it and apply some color, arrange it to back like that, and let's pick this color. V, select. The color code for this is ECDCCB, so copy this and we'll select this one and apply the color. V, paste, click OK. And for this as well, so double click on it, or maybe just we'll expand this first. Go expand, click OK, then go in there, ungroup it, and we are left with this. So go there, delete this out, delete this top surface, then delete this as well. And for this, we're gonna apply the color. So paste it, V, OK. And let's come out, and here we go. We have applied that nice color, this light brown color, and for the rest, it's black. So we got the text black and everything black. And here, if you zoom it in, you see some gradient over here. You can leave it or you can just make it darker. So finally, we have completed creating all the vintage logo designs. We have started out with this, and we have seen all the necessary steps you need to know to create this effect. We have almost used all the tools from here, from the toolbar, and created out this amazing vector logo design. First one was helmet with a nice retro look, then this one with a nice workshop logo, which is quite unique. Then we have created this anchor ship logo with a classic look to it, and after that we have created this unique vintage logo with a nice background color to the vector object. We have created that using the image and then added it. And we have learned how you can use the text to give a round shape using the ellipse tool. And lastly, we have created this design, and for this, apply this black color for the deer as well. So this way we have completed creating out this vintage logo design. So in this tutorial, overall, we have first understand how we can use the image and convert them into path object in Photoshop, and it become Very easy to convert it into vectors in Illustrator, and after that you can use it in any way you like. Like you want to use it in an illustration, you want to use it in logo design, or you want to create something else. So it gives you the freedom to create any design you like, and all of the five logo we have created in this tutorial are unique in their own way. And if you will check out in the internet, you'll find lots of websites where they give you vintage logo like templates, where you can just directly go there and download them, and you can just change the text and your final logo is ready. So there is one way where you can go and download the templates and create the logo. Another way you can is by designing from scratch, by developing your own ideas and developing a nice vintage logo. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.